You're tuned to 1290 WHKY.
Good morning. Welcome back to First Talk with Hal Rowe on 1290 WHKY Talk Radio for the Greater Hickory Metro. I got to say, two of my favorite people in the community, and I was thinking about this, if you go over their resumes and all that they've done over the years, so just since I've known them, well, it would take us all an hour to discuss what they've done in the past, but we'll talk a little bit about that this morning, but also what they're doing now. Jeff and Carol Ann Hartman, I want to thank both of you very much for joining us this morning. Of course, we're going to be talking about Hickory Arts. Good to see y'all.
Good to see you. Thanks for having us.
You're more than welcome. That's very nice. They did not rehearse that as far as I know. Actually, some of the first guests that we ever had on the program. When Scott Jeffries Band, mm-hmm. and Jeff has done, I know that you've done work with Hickory Community Theater for a number of years, Carol Ann, you as well, and mm-hmm. I think that's, if I'm not mistaken, did y'all meet on the stage at Hickory Community Theater or backstage? Was it a show? Because I know that y'all knew each other kind of through the theater and did some mm-hmm. things there for a period of time at the Hickory Community Theater.
Yeah, we met on stage, not at the Hickory Community Theater, but we met doing a show.
We ended up getting married on stage at Hickory Community Theater.
So theater, a big part of your life and what you've done. Some of the things that I can just remember and just kind of pick out here real quick. Complete works of William Shakespeare, Abridged, mm-hmm. was one of the things that I think that you may be known for. That do people still comment on that and the original cast? Because I know that you've just reprised that recently.
Yeah.
But was that one of the original things that kind of people may remember you from and that you were proud of and felt real good about as far as your work?
Yeah, that show did so well when we originally did it that prompted them to ask us to do it again this season.
Well, people would call up and ask them to do it again.
Really?
People, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And I'm going to guess Chicago. What's one of the ones that you kind of take a look back and maybe people say, "Wow, that was really good. That was the right role for you, and you nailed it." What would you say in your past with the theater or any of the work that you've done that people may remember you from?
Yeah, I guess Chicago would be a good one. More recently, Sound of Music.
Okay.
I get lots of comments. That one sold out almost every night. So I'll be somewhere and some random stranger will come up and ask me if I was in that. So,
really?
Yeah.
See, now that's got to feel good because, I mean, you all have done a lot of great work in community theater and a lot of other things as well. Carolyn, you're a photography.
Mm-hmm.
Jeff, of course, you just recently did the music for, when I say recently, it was in the past year, did a great job, if I'm not mistaken, Full Monty. Mm-hmm. So I'm bringing up a couple of highlights here just that people may recognize. But again, just to go over the depth and the breadth of the work that y'all have done over the years would take quite a time. So I'm just kind of letting people know some of the things. And help me with the maybe I've missed something there. Is there something that you're particularly proud of or something that you'd like to bring up maybe that I've missed that you've been doing or some work that you've done in the past that you feel very good about?
Well, this is actually, there's actually a nice segue because you just had Joe Barrett on.
Right.
And we just did a senior project. No, I'm Spanish.
Latino community has loved it.
Yes. A senior project with his son, Kevin, and he was studying sound engineering and wanted to learn more about audio operating in film. So we were able to do that with him through Hickory Arts, and that's something I'm recently very proud of. He told me, he messaged me and said he got a perfect score on his project and was very proud of it. So
I don't know if you can see him. He's giving a thumbs up while he's talking about
it. Yes, I'm very visual when I talk. Yeah. So.
But that was a good thing for you.
Yeah, it really made me feel like what we're doing is what we're supposed to be doing.
You've done a lot of classes in digital photography and mm-hmm. other types of photography and things coming up like that. Are you just shooting a lot of video now?
Yeah.
Because you were film, right, for a number of years and then all of a sudden it was digital?
Yeah. I grew up shooting film. My dad actually had a digital darkroom in,
really?
In a closet in the house and taught me how to use my mom's old film camera and we developed ourselves and stuff. And so when digital came out and I really I mean, I just shot for fun since I was in middle school, you know, and he taught me. And so when digital came out and I actually had a need for it in my business, you know, Jeff actually gifted me a digital camera and it just went from there and it started becoming a business. But yeah, we've switched a lot to video as well.
I had no idea that you had that, but the dark room, the old fixers and all the chemicals and, you know, and all that kind of stuff, that was really magical.
And I
could kind of understand, you know, how that would, you know, and especially like doing it with your dad and, you know, that had to be very special in that time. So just another thing that we kind of take a look back and very proud of and feel real good about that history of photography. Well, let's talk a little bit about Hickory Arts. First of all, someone help me with, there's so much going on because I wanted to do a little show prep. Believe it or not, I'm actually doing show prep these days. just kind of caught on the past 6 months or so. It seemed like a good idea. But I went to your website. We had a great website, by the way.
Thank you.
And there's so much going on that I kind of want to, if you would, to kind of boil it down for us and give us just a general working idea of what's happening with Hickory Arts and something for us just to kind of start with, because we have a lot to talk about this morning. So kind of give us just an idea of what Hickory Arts may be or a good way to define it.
I think the easiest way to define it is that we take performance artists from point A to point B, whatever that may be. And that's actors, that's musicians, that's singers, that's songwriters. Eventually, we'd love to incorporate visual arts in there as well, but right now it's performance artists. And that may be somebody who wants to get a part in the play. And so they come in and do some, you know, a couple weeks of coaching before the audition. That may be someone who sits at home and doodles songs but doesn't know what to do with them, and they want to be able to, you know, record them or put them to music. Or that may be someone who sits around and sings in the shower and they want to get up on stage. And so we try to teach them to get from that point A to point B. We're very particular about not just throwing something at them and saying, well, here, you go do this. You know, we don't do open mic nights and we don't do things like that, but we will teach them the steps that it takes to get there in very specific detail, if that makes sense.
Sure. And this is, I guess, just because of the nature of it, it's custom tailored to whatever an individual's need may be.
Yes.
Wherever their point A is at this time, and wherever their point B, wherever they like to be, you know, wherever they like to arrive, y'all can help with that.
Yeah, we're very specialized, and we limit our teachers with how many students they can have.
Teachers. Okay, very good. We'll talk more about the classes, the teachers, and Hickory Arts with the Hartmans. More First Talk right after this. Welcome back to First Talk with Hal Rowe on 1290 WHKY Talk Radio for the Greater Hickory Metro. We're talking this morning about Hickory Arts, helping performance artists get from point A to point B, wherever they are and whether they where they want to arrive. Carol Ann and Jeff Hartman join us this morning, the owners, operators, creators of Hickory Arts. And let's talk a little bit about the different classes and what's being offered now, because even though it is specifically tailored to an individual client's or student's need, there are certain things that you can offer in a general sense. And so let's talk about some of those. One of the, where would you like to start? Is it voice? Is it music? Or tell me where you all would like to start, and we'll just kind of talk about some of the things that may help performance artists.
Sure. We have kind of a big list. It is anything performance-wise. We have voice. We have Jeff actually specializes in working with songwriters. So he works with a lot of kids and adults that are songwriters and helps them mold what they're doing and get that out there. But we've got, you know, all of the band instruments, guitar, bass, drums, piano. We have two different kinds of piano. We have Jeff that teaches by ear and chord, and then we have John Coffey that teaches classical piano as well as classical voice and Broadway voice. And then we've actually just added a whole slew of teachers so that we have brass, wind instruments, string instruments covered as well.
Now, are these, are some of these group lessons, individual lessons? If somebody calls you and says, hey, you know, I I played saxophone in high school or whatever. I don't know if saxophone is offered, but whatever instrument I played, and I'd really like to start playing again. I might like to play in community theater in the band there, where we're putting a band together. You'll be able to direct them towards a certain instructor.
Yes. Right. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Right now they're all private lessons. We do have on the horizon some acting classes, some group classes for kids and adults. That's coming a little ways down the road. But
now some of these involve, of course, the lessons involve a cost. Some you host at either low cost or no cost. I know that you had a singer, a songwriter's symposium and had the King of Pop. I'm not the King of Pop, but the help me
Prince
with
Pop.
The Prince of Pop. That's exactly right. And his you did this. This was for people who were interested in songwriting. It was actually a couple days, like a weekend. Tell me about that. And that was one that was at a cost, and it was for people who may be interested in this profession. Tell me about that one.
Yeah, we had a master class over the
Kyle Vincent.
He came down from New England, and it was a great success. It was for people who wanted to learn more about singer-songwriter development, whether you were a beginner or someone who was already established who wanted to learn more about the industry and publishing, and so it covered the whole spectrum.
Yeah.
And that was great. That lasted, he did a house concert for us the night before,
right.
And then the class lasted the following day from 10 to 6.
Throughout the day. Right?
And it was a huge success, great response, and a lot of people walked away with it wanting more. And Kyle has actually talked about coming back and doing a week-long workshop this summer.
So I wanted to kind of get people an idea of what the Hickory Arts may be on one level. Mm-hmm. Another level is you're offering a class now that's free and open to the public regarding choices and defining characters for somebody who may be wanting to pursue acting professionally, or Hickory Community Theater or Green Room or Foothills or wherever it may be, community theater or acting. Mm-hmm. And tell us a little bit about that now.
Yeah,
we've actually got coming up January 26th. It's actually in cahoots with the Hickory Community Theater as well as the Charlotte Comedy Theater.
Okay.
It's an improv class, so it's great for anybody that wants to either hone their skills in acting, or that's maybe not quite sure what it's all about and wants to get into it.
Now, is this the one that's free and open to the public,
yes.
Making difficult choices or making a clear choice? I can't remember the actual how it was promoted, but this is defining characters through difficult choices or something like that.
Exactly.
But this happens now. Where will this be held?
This will be held at our facility. It'll be held at Hickory Arts. We've got this great guy, Jason Spooner, who's coming up from Charlotte. He's the creative director of the Charlotte Comedy Theater, and he's going to come up and run the class. We've got spaces for 30, so we've filled, almost...
Close to 20. There. We're getting close quickly.
But it is free and open to anybody 12 and older.
Okay.
Yeah.
So this is, and people look at improv. They may look at Whose Line Is It Anyway? Very popular on television for a while. Kind of went away. It's kind of coming back. But they think about improv. They don't realize that there are some very specific rules and some steps that you take. It's kind of a misnomer at some point, because while you are creating and while you're doing improvisation, there are certain rules and certain things that you put in place to make sure everybody's kind of on the same page.
Yeah, there are wrong ways to do improv.
Right. It's a good way to put it. Right. And you can kind of see that in some improv troops or so this will kind of give people a general idea of how to do that, and also how to develop characters. Is that right? So maybe somebody who has thought about community theater, maybe someone thought about, I haven't acted in a while, or I'd like to make better choices, or I'd like to improve, again going from that point A to point B.
Mm-hmm. Yes, and it's a great opportunity for someone in a large group setting too. It's not, there's no pressure. Everyone is there on the same page. Everyone's being supportive of each other. So even somebody that's never done it before can walk in and feel supported trying to get up there and do this for the first time.
Now this, if I'm not mistaken, this started literally as a cottage industry out of your home, but you do have a facility now. You have a working place of business that you do a lot of these classes and a lot of this takes place. Tell us about that.
Mm-hmm. We do.
We do. It's located on 2nd Avenue Southwest across from Hickory Optimist Park.
Okay.
And it's a great little place. We've got four main session rooms, private session rooms, that also double as recording booths. We've got an open cabaret space which can seat up to 40 people. And we've done a lot of our house concerts and group sessions in there. And we've got a master control room. Carol's got her own photography vault. It actually used to be a fireproof vault. So it's a big brick enclosure, and it's really cool. Mm-hmm. She's done a lot of stuff in there. Actually, this time last year, she was doing free Valentine's Day photographs for people.
Now, this is, because we're talking about performance, are you doing those? Are you doing your photography classes in conjunction, in concert with Hickory Arts, or is that something that's separate that you're doing differently?
It's something that I do under my business name, but I do them in conjunction with Hickory Arts. I use the facility there, and we kind of cross advertise them. I only do probably two classes a year because I do big classes. I do private lessons as well. So I've done quite a few private lessons there, but
As far as photography.
Right. Yeah. I will work one-on-one with people with photography, and then I've got the big group classes, and we've got one actually coming up in March.
Okay. Well, tell us about that. That happens when?
That happens March 2nd. It's a Saturday. It's an all-day class. It's 10 to 6. We stop and break for lunch, but we cover everything. People can bring their cameras in, and it's mostly the DSLR cameras, and for people who don't know what that is, it's usually the camera that you can take the lens off and put a new one on.
Okay.
That's the easiest way to describe it for people who don't know what they have. But we actually learn how to shoot in manual. That's what we start with. We start with what the camera does and how to make it do what you want it to do yourself instead of relying on it.
Yeah, the single reflex lens cameras that they used to have, of course, you'd have to worry about aperture. Mm-hmm. You'd have to worry about shutter speed so much. That's where you kind of started.
Yes.
And now we can see this now translating into and being able to be creative with digital cameras, mm-hmm. because now they are, it used to be, when the digital cameras came out, they were all point and shoot, or pretty much.
Yes.
They were pretty much, you pick it up, you take a shot, and then you download it to your computer, and everything. Oh, it's magic, you know. Now there's the ability to be somewhat more creative with your photography, going back to what you may have seen with the old 35 millimeter photography.
Exactly. What I tell my students is teaching them to be smarter than the camera.
That's good. That's a good thing, because that's tough.
Some of these cameras
are pretty darn smart.
They are. They're very smart, but sometimes you just can't get what you want to get, and you don't know why until you really learn to shoot in manual.
Until you really learn to shoot in manual. More First Talk right after this.
News and talk of Hickory, 1290 WHKY.
Good morning. Welcome back to First Talk with Hal Rowe on 1290 WHKY Talk Radio for the Greater Hickory Metro. We're talking about Hickory Arts this morning. It is a private company that helps performance artists get from point A to point B in their careers or in their pursuits. It doesn't have to be professional. It could be someone who wants to move from singing in the shower to maybe singing in their church choir.
Sure.
Or just singing and being able to do that. Jeff and Carolyn Hartman, our guests this morning, the owners of Hickory Arts. I'm going to ask you this. This is how did this come about? How did y'all decide that, you know, because you're both, actors and musicians and, you pursue the arts, I mean, the photography, the acting, the music. How did you decide that, okay, this is something that we want to do and we want to bring this to others?
Do I get to tell them the honest answer?
Sure, whatever that is.
Oh, Jeff's scared now. Jeff has actually been teaching music since he was, like, in high school, college.
I started in college.
Yeah.
Okay.
And so just teaching on his own and then with the different facilities and then on his own again. And so it just got to the point where we looked at each other and said, okay, we're getting old. We've got to do something real with this. And so, you know, we had talked with John Coffey, who was coming back to the area, and got some donations from friends and family that were really in support of us doing this so that we could get off the ground. And it, that's really what it came out of. It came out of we need to make something real for ourselves, for our kids, for our future.
Sure, because oftentimes, we were talking about this during the break, if you're in a band, oftentimes that means late Saturday nights, mm-hmm. it means load out, it means load in, it means, okay, great, we got paid this week, you know, and we didn't have to, you know, we didn't have to threaten anybody. Yeah. That's part of it. So actually actually putting it into practice, actually having a place where you can do it, an actual address, a business license, and becoming, you are already credible because of your talents and abilities, but being able to put that kind of under a roof.
Exactly. Well, incorporate other people and other teachers. And Jeff has gotten so many compliments from his students over the years and his students' parents of what a great teacher he is. So it just was the right move, you know, to make.
Well, and as we were looking for other opportunities of what we could do with our skills, Carol was talking on the break, playing music. A lot of artists think, well, there's only one way to make money in this business, and that's just performing. But there are so many other avenues, scoring, getting your music placed in film and television, and all these other avenues. So as we were discovering all this, we wanted to make those avenues clear to other up-and-coming mm-hmm. artists as well. So,
and we're also very big on collaboration and working mm-hmm. with other companies, even companies outside of our industry, you know, things that we can do to pull in other people and help other businesses, and you scratch our back, we'll scratch yours kind of thing. And
sure.
So now we have that hub, that business, that official space.
Y'all could have really done this anywhere. You're both young folks. You could have gone to Charlotte with this. You could have gone to Winston-Salem. You got the School of the Arts there. You could have gone to Raleigh, Greensboro. Why Hickory?
Silence.
Well, I mean, I think it's the same.
I ask this question for a couple reasons. I talk with entrepreneurs every day. We talk mm-hmm. with the Chamber of Commerce, who has the Edison Awards, and people who put mm-hmm. together. We work with the small business folks who, and basically, you know, this, because when I was thinking about y'all coming in, not only are you artists, and not only you're instructors and teachers, you're also entrepreneurs. You've started a new business. You're employing people. Mm-hmm. You know, you're putting people to work. You are workforce development. Mm-hmm. You know, when you have people who are working and who are either shooting video or giving instruction, that's so. Why Hickory? You know, because like I said, you could do it just about anywhere. And I know that may be and if it's a personal question, you can just say, well, let's just move on.
I stopped and looked at him because I didn't know if he wanted to answer, and he didn't know if I wanted to answer.
Well, and you pick this up and run with it, but I think for me, Hickory has always been a great crossroads. I mean, you can drive right up the mountain, less than an hour. You can drive up to Asheville, less than, you know, Charlotte. You can go, we're right in the middle of so much. And I think that's why a lot of people choose to live here. Mm-hmm. And so
you can go see a football game, you can go see a concert, but you don't have to deal with the traffic.
Right.
You don't have to deal with a lot of the other negatives that you have with being a resident of those areas, but able to get there.
Hickory also is just it's an art-supportive community.
Yes, it is. I don't think that there's any doubt about that. Mm-hmm. I mean, I think that you take a look at what's happened in, you know, Newton Conover area with the Green Room and the renovations there, and the money that's been put in there, what's happening with the Hickory Community Theater, and, you know, a lot of people behind the scenes there. Foothills, it doesn't matter.
But. Yeah, you got the Newton Conover Auditorium that's trying to bring in larger acts and trying to, you know, make that a hub too. So, I mean, we do have an art supportive area, and we've got a lot of people that want to infuse themselves into that don't know how.
Mm-hmm. So, I got to give real quick just the Hickory Community Theater and people there. I mean, you go see, I've lived in a lot of different communities, and you go to the Hickory Community Theater and you go, wow, there's talent. And just about anybody you talk to, you say, we have this. So not only is the community supportive of arts, you got a lot of artists here.
Yes.
You got a lot of people who are very talented.
Yeah, we're working with Molly Bass and developing a new musical with her.
Oh, great.
Where, you know, John Coffey's right there in the studio, and mm-hmm. he's an original composer. And there's so much creativity.
I want to talk a little bit about your instructors. You've got John Coffey, mm-hmm. and give me a real, give me a real quick bio in case somebody's not familiar with John Coffey. Very brief, very basic. Well, let's do Broadway.
Yeah, right.
Okay.
He's been off in New York for 11 years, 12 years, playing in the pit and music directing Broadway and off-Broadway shows and traveling.
National touring.
Right.
Actually, international touring.
Yeah.
I mean, he's been to
Russia,
Scotland. He was on Three Modivas toured, I want to say, on cruise ships and went all over the place.
Has made a good living pursuing his art and what he likes doing. So you're able to use his talents and abilities and his experience at Hickory Arts.
Yes.
Okay, who else have you got on board now? Are you working with anybody else, or does it come up as needed?
It's usually as needed, but we have Diana Stone, who's handling the string instruments. She plays with the symphony.
Okay.
And she does a lot of pit work for community theater. Stephen Foster, who was actually in the pit with me for Full Monty. He just came on board for wind instruments.
Okay.
We have Matt Decker. He was in the pit for Full Monty. Mm-hmm. He does percussion. Amali Henson, who is a vocal technique teacher. She actually taught Carol. She's
fabulous.
She is at LR. She works with LR as well.
Mm-hmm. So these are some of the folks that people, when they work with Hickory Arts, you have access to them, and you're able to say, someone comes in and says, I need some help with voice. Okay, we're going to set you up here.
Yep.
Someone, we need some help with theater. Okay. It can be me, or it can be this individual, mm-hmm. depending on what you need. So they may not be on staff at all times, but are available and able to work with individuals. So you're kind of a clearinghouse for coaching as well.
Yep.
And we're always looking for both students that maybe need something that we don't offer, we'll try to go find it, but also teachers that want to come in and be part of our team. We're always keeping our eyes open for anybody that we can incorporate.
Mm-hmm. Very good. I've got a couple other things that I want to talk about before we wrap up this morning, because I want to talk about a couple of the artists that you're working with now. Mm-hmm. But real quick, just in case someone's got to go during the break, contact, what's the best way to reach Hickory Arts, either of you, or to find out more?
We have website. It's just very simple, hickoryarts.com.
Right.
And all of our contact information is on there, but we also have a phone number that conveniently rings directly to either of us, whoever's available. We grab it. It's 828-270-
Uh-huh. 9801.
Yep.
More First Talk after this break. Good morning. Welcome back to First Talk with Hal Rowe on 1290 WHKY Talk Radio for the Greater Hickory Metro. I want to thank you both very much for joining us this morning, Carol Ann and Jeff Hartman. And I've known you all for a number of years. I'm just so happy now that that you guys are together, happy with the family. And Timmy and the twins. Timmy and the twins. And, of course, now it was your first son named Timmy, or Timothy, right?
Mm-hmm.
And your two other boys, right?
Yep. Coble and Kellen.
Coble.
And Kellen.
And Kellen. And I want to say that's a family name.
Yes.
There's a family name in there.
Yes. Coble is my maiden name.
I didn't want to say, I'm glad you said that. Didn't know, you know, legal, you know.
Oh, no,
what's all the check or the checkbook, you know, I didn't know about that. And then, they are how old, the twins?
The twins are 7.
Oh,
Everybody this year, we have all the birthdays are early. So Timmy's almost 11 and the twins are almost 8.
Wow.
Yeah. Isn't that crazy?
Yeah, that really is. But I'm glad that they are doing well, and I'm glad this has come about for you, because you're off the road, you're in Hickory, you're able to, I mean, I didn't even mention Hartman, the work that y'all have done as far as singers, songwriters, and getting together, mm-hmm. and that type of performance. Mm-hmm. But before we wrap up this morning, I know that we could talk a lot about the scores that you've done. Mm-hmm. You've worked with movies. There's television commercials that you're shooting. There's a whole lot of other stuff. Mm-hmm. But let's talk about kind of the meat and potatoes, if you will, of what you're doing. Let's talk about a couple of your students.
Yes.
Yeah.
Hey, you work with the Moore brothers, too, which is pretty cool.
Yes, the Moore brothers. I actually have a session with them today at 1:30. I love working with those guys. They're so talented. It's unbelievable. And they just did the concert with Robert Kearns. We were talking about that. And
So and I'm trying to think of the older one. It's not Joshua. I'm trying to think of the older one's name. It's I can't remember the one who plays a little violin, but
It was Jake and Isaac.
Isaac. Okay, yeah. He was the one who when we were in, they played. Let me play a little guitar, and we played a little bluegrass number, and yeah. he played fiddle, not violin, uh-huh. fiddle at that
fiddle,
point.
Yes.
But a lot of fun. Good kids. Yeah. But you've got a couple young ladies. Who are kind of happening and kind of got some things going on. And I'll let you give you each a minute or two to talk about them
sure.
before we wrap up. Caroline,
sure,
yeah. do you want to start?
Yeah. Yeah, sure. Well, I mean, all of our students are doing phenomenally.
Yeah.
So
okay,
we don't
yeah.
want to, you know, we hate to just single out a couple, but.
Yeah, tell them I did that.
Yeah, okay.
It was Hal
was
who did
Hal's
this.
You know? Yeah, yes. yeah. No, we've got a couple that have just recently come, had some stuff go public.
Right.
We've got Ms. Shannon Underwood, who, if you visit our website, is one of the first videos that you see. She helped us do some of the fundraising that we did. She's been with Jeff since before we opened Hickory Arts, and so
okay.
she's adorable little bubbly personality on the video that we've got up there. But she is actually recording an album. She has written and is in the process of recording, which is another thing that we offer at Hickory Arts is recording. And
right.
she just released the first track off of that album as a single and is so proud of it because she's got it up on iTunes and on CD Baby, and it's for digital download, and has just done the whole shebang with that. And so we're very proud of her and everything that she has managed to accomplish, because she's an adult now, working, you know, living on her own and stuff. So to make time to develop her art is a big deal.
One of the reasons I wanted to mention these two artists is because of this is what can happen with Hickory Arts and what you're kind of doing.
Exactly.
So I want to let people know. Now, who else, Jeff? You're working with somebody else, another young lady.
Yeah. Allie Adams is, she's newer to Hickory Arts. We started working with her in the fall, and she has just recorded and released her first music video. And she did a cover of It Must Have Been Love, mm-hmm. The old rock set tune. And she's got an amazing voice, very old school, very Etta James sounding. Mm. And that's you can see that on the Hickory Arts YouTube page, actually, yeah. right now. And but she's in the process.
Right now. Go right,
right
now.
Now. But she's in the process of releasing her first original single accompanied with that cover of that song. So
yeah.
And from what I understand, and this is really not for for on air, but each one of these artists is unique in that there was a journey mm-hmm. that they needed to take from point A to point B.
Yeah.
And they may have reached that, you know, point A, point five, or whatever,
mm-hmm.
and are on their way to B. Mm-hmm. But this is one of the things that Hickory Arts can kind of help out with and kind of work with a performance artist. We wish you both the very best and continued success. And as things expand and you do more, mm-hmm. Please keep us in touch and let us know. I want to come over and I want to see the studios. I want to come
yeah.
over and take a walk through. Mm-hmm. And do you have a guitar over there that I can borrow?
Anytime.
Anytime.
And
yeah.
You've got one and we can, you know, sit down. And,
yeah.
Great. Very good. I look forward to it. Carol Ann and Jeff Hartman have been our guests this morning. Hickory Arts. Before we wrap up, one more time, 270-9801. That's area, of course, 828-270-9801. If you're old school like me and you still use the telephone, of course, the website, hickoryarts.com.
Yep.
Very good. Thank you again both for joining us this morning.
Thank you.
We're going to go ahead and close the way we normally do, Monday through Thursday, with the greatest. Well, excuse me. It's not National Anthem Day. Normally we do. It's Friday. Oh, yeah, it is Friday. And everybody in here smiling. Susie Woods, I know I'm smiling. I love my job, but I love the weekend as well. We're going to go ahead and close the way we normally do on Fridays with Happy Trails.
Happy trails to you until we meet again. Happy trails to you. Keep smiling. The clouds if we're together.
Just sing a song and bring the sunny weather.
Happy trails to you till we meet again. Some trails are happy ones, others are blue. It's the way you ride that trail. Here's a happy one for you.
Happy trails to you. It's great to say hello and to share with you the trail we've come to know.
It started on the day that we met Jesus.
He came into our hearts and then he freed us
for a life.
Thanks so much for joining us on First Talk. We know you have a choice in morning radio. That's why we appreciate you choosing the First Talk radio program. Earlier this week, when we were talking, last week, we were talking with Catawba County Public Health. Remember, they do have the flu vaccine in, so please make your appointment. Go to Catawba County Health. Get that flu shot. Just one of the things that we'll take you everywhere on this show. We'll keep you healthy, and we'll keep you entertained. And don't forget, next week, we'll have those Sugar Mountain ski passes that we will give away, a couple lift tickets, or we'll send you ice skating. You and the family will send you ice skating up there to Sugar Mountain. That'll be next week on the First Talk radio program. Plus that, Susie and I have got a great, great array of shows lined up for you next week, so we hope you'll join us then. Be grateful for what you got. Make it a great day. We'll talk next week on First Talk with Hal Rowe. Again, if you are interested in the program this morning, 270-9801. HickoryArts.com is the number there. And if you have a guest suggestion for the First Talk radio program, you contact us at talk@WHKY.com. That's talk@WHKY.com. Let us know who you'd like to have on the air, why you think they'd make a great guest. We'd love to talk to them. Or if you have a topic that we haven't explored that you'd like to hear us talk about, open the phone lines for comment. We'd like to hear from you as well. Phone line is a little bit busy in the morning. Susie's here, so use the email. talk@WHKY.com. talk@WHKY.com. Be grateful for what you got. We'll talk Monday.
With Hal Rowe.